I was in the building because I was driving a friend. So I'm worried for her safety. And I pray for her to be all right.
Spend all your time waiting.
The victims were in airplanes.
For that second chance.
Or in their offices.
For a break that would make it okay.
Moms and dads, friends and neighbors.
I can
feel it.
Terror, disbelief.
Feel not good enough.
Terrible sadness.
And it's hard at the end.
And a quiet, unyielding anger.
I need some distraction.
We must be strong.
Oh.
I heard a collective scream. The shriek lasted for quite a long time.
And this sweet madness.
What is going on?
All this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees.
In our nation's most wanted tolerance for all peoples, our enemies have found our Achilles heel.
In the
victims, pray for the missing,
from this dark cold hotel,
and the loved ones holding vigil,
and the endlessness that you feel
between hope and despair.
From the
you can hear firefighters that are still trapped, crying,
people walking around like ghosts. Wandering, dazed.
America was targeted for attack because we're the brightest beacon for freedom. And no one will keep that light from shining. Tonight I ask for your prayers for all those who grieve. And I pray they will be comforted by a power greater than any of us, spoken through the ages in Psalm 23. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me.